So hi everyone and welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247. मैं हूं मनीष मिश्रा and in today's session guys I will bring to you some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD. And NABARD का exam बस आने ही वाला है, so I hope you all are revising the stuffs and इस time कोई भी नई चीज को करने की कोशिश मत करना. जितनी भी चीजें आपने कंप्लीट कर ली हैं, just keep on revising those things. ऐसा ना हो कि एग्जाम में पढ़ी हुई चीजें भी गलत करके आ जाओ. एक स्टूडेंट का मेरे पास सिमिलरली एक मैसेज आया था कि आई एम गेटिंग कंफ्यूज्ड इन विद इन द ऑप्शंस. सो द ओनली रीजन टू गेट कंफ्यूज्ड विद इन द ऑप्शंस इज द लैक ऑफ रिवीजन. यू आर नॉट रिवाइजिंग प्रॉपरली, दिस इज द ओनली रीजन. और ये बहुत ही खतरनाक है, बहुत ही खतरनाक सिंड्रोम है फॉर द एग्जामिनेशन. ऑलराइट, सो हमें इसको दूर करना होगा. वी नीड टू गेट रिड ऑफ दिस कंफ्यूजन एंड द ओनली वे इज मोर एंड मोर रिवीजन. सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द टुडे सेशन गाइज. But before we begin, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group. Here you will get the PDF of this session. And pichle session ka PDF miss ho gaya tha. After today's session, you will get the PDF of today's session and also the last session. Okay. So let's talk about the very first question then. And guys, in today's session, the questions are very easy. The news are very easy. Aur bahut choti choti news hai aaj ke session mein. Jaldi se padh ke khatam karte hain aur 5 number pakke karte hain apne. With which of the following institutes of ICAR, Indian Council of Agricultural Research, APIDA has signed an MOU for increasing exports through quality production and processing. APIDA ne ek MOU sign kiya hai for increasing exports through quality production and processing. Processing of what? Agar main of what bata deta to fir is question ka answer bahut easily aa jata. So this MOU guys has been signed for increasing the export through quality production and processing of millets. Okay, millets ke liye. But so now you can easily answer this question now. Since this MOU is regarding the increasing the export of millets, so the correct answer to this question is Indian Institute of Millet Research, which is located in Hyderabad. Which is located where? It is in Hyderabad. So now let's talk more about this news. So this MOU has been signed between APIDA and IIMR, Indian Institute of Millet Research. And remember this also that IIMR is located in Hyderabad and this has been done for increasing exports through quality production and processing of millets. Okay, now the key focus of this MOU, this MOU ka jo key focus hoga, that will be on the export. Wo hame question mein pata chal gaya hai. Other than that, to promote commercial cultivation of processable varieties developed by ICAR IIMR. Number two, to create market linkages with farmers as well as the farmer producer organizations. Jo farmers hain aur jo farmer producer organizations hain unke sath market ko link karna. And number 3, of course, to build the export centric ecosystem jisme sare ke sare infrastructure available ho that can boost the export of millets. All right, of course, export karna hai to uske liye export centric ecosystem banana padega and that is the part of this MOU. All right, so this guys is about this news and now let's come back to the question. The correct answer is what? Indian Institute of Millet Research, which is located in Hyderabad. All right, now moving ahead to question number 2. This is again regarding an MOU with which of the following universities, National E-Governance Division. Now what is this National E-Governance Division, NEGD? NEGD guys, it was established in the year 2009 and it has the objective of implementing all the e-governance projects of the government of India. भारत सरकार के जितने भी e-governance के projects हैं, उसको implement कराने का काम किसका होता है? NEGD का. And it was established in the year 2009 under Ministry of Electronics and IT. Ministry of Electronics and IT के अंदर ये काम करता है. So the question now is with which of the following universities, National E-Governance Division has signed an MOU to establish a cyber lab. Now what is this cyber lab? This is for online capacity building program on cyber law, crime investigation and digital forensics. Let's talk about this news and then we will come back to the question. So remember, this MOU has been signed with NLU Delhi, National Law University Delhi and National Law Institute University Bhopal, NLIU Bhopal. This is guys very important question. Do remember this because these days government is talking very much about the technologies. So technology se related question exam mein bahut puche ja rahe hain aajkal and this MOU NEGD ne sign kiya hai with NLU Delhi and NLIU Bhopal for what? For making a cyber lab. And what will this cyber lab do? Ye cyber lab kya karega? It will guys, it will be a online capacity building program. It will, you know, build the capacity of the Delhi police, of the police officers, of the CBI officers of the NIA officials regarding what? Regarding cyber law, crime investigation and digital forensics. Alright. So this is the objective of this cyber lab, and the goal of the program, as I told you, to enable police officers and the likes like CBI officials and NIA officials to acquire requisite skills to deal with the cyber forensics. Alright. And for this, a PG diploma will be provided by NIGD in collaboration with NIU Bhopal. 9 month long ye PG diploma hoga, and it will be provided to 1000 officials, and for that the e-content will be developed by NIGD, National E-Governance Division. Okay, so I hope this news is clear, and now let's come back to the question. So we have to tell the name of the university. So number one is National University Delhi, and then we have National Law Institute University Bhopal. So only 1 and 5 should be the correct answer, option C. And now let's move ahead to question number 3. Which of the following power companies has got Dun & Bradstreet Award in the category of Best Growth Performance Power? Best Growth Performance ke liye bahut sari categories thi isme, and in the category of power, which of the following power companies has got this award, which is known as Dun & Bradstreet Award? Remember guys, this Dun & Bradstreet Awards provide a list of top 500 companies in the India separately, and then there are various categories of awards also. Alright, ek jo ye Dun & Bradstreet Award hai, isme 500 companies, top 500 companies batata hai, aur iske alawa alag more than 30 plus indicators ke hisab se alag alag awardees bhi ye ghoshit karta hai. Alright, so let's talk about this news. Remember SJVN, Satluj Jal Vidyut Nigam Limited. Satluj Jal Vidyut Nigam Limited, which is a public sector enterprise, and it is a joint enterprise of Government of India and Government of Himachal Pradesh. Government of India or Government of Himachal Pradesh ka joint venture hai. It was established in the year 1988, incorporated in the year 1988, and it is headquartered in Shimla. Shimla, which is of course in Himachal Pradesh. So it is a joint venture of Government of India and Government of Himachal Pradesh, and this Satluj Jal Vidyut Nigam Limited has got this award in the Best Growth Performance category in the category of power. Alright, and what award? Dun & Bradstreet Award 2021. Now talking more about the awards. So the awards, I have told you, it gives a list of top 500 companies in the India. The number one company is 3M India Limited. 3M India Limited, according to this award. And there are various other categories of awards also. There are more than 30 category of awards. And the theme for this year was laying the foundation for an ESG ready corporate India. Laying the foundation for an ESG ready corporate India. Now what is the meaning of ESG? Environmental social governance. Environmental social governance. Okay. Moving ahead to the category of prizes. Ye kuch alag alag categories ke winners hai, unke baare mein pata hona chahiye. Like best growth performance in the category of banks. It's Bandhan Bank Limited. Bandhan Bank Limited is headquartered in Kolkata. It is headquartered in Kolkata, and Chandrasekhar Ghosh is the CEO, and he was recently reappointed by the RBI for a period of three years. Best Growth Performance Engineering Products mein Rights Limited. Best Growth Performance in the terms of NBFC financial institutions is Bajaj Finance Limited. Sector awards ki baat kare, in the terms of bank, the number one bank in India is HDFC Bank, and don't get confused between HDFC and Bandhan. It is the best growth performance bank, Bandhan Bank. If the question is regarding the sector award in the case of bank, then that is HDFC Bank. CEO of course is Shashidhar Jagdishan. Sector awards in the case of insurance, SBI Life, and sector awards in case of FMCG, it's Hindustan Unilever Limited as always. So guys, this was about this news, and now let's come back to the question. And if you remember, SJVN is the same company with which the Government of India is building a Arun Hydroelectric Power Project in Nepal. So the correct answer to this question is option B, SJVN. Now moving ahead to question number 4, which is regarding the MNREGA. See guys, this question is not so much important, but yes, since it is regarding a government scheme, so I have taken this scheme. Aur bahut aasan question hai, in my opinion, it will come in phase 1, but yes, in ESI also we have phase 1 mein ESI bhi hai, toh NABARD ke paper mein. तो इसलिए ये क्वेश्चन पूछा जा सकते हैं, एंड ऑफ कोर्स इन आरबीआई आल्सो दे आल्सो आस्क क्वेश्चन ऑफ वन मार्कर इन ईएसआई इन फेज 2. सो एक नंबर मार्क्स में तो पूछा जा सकता है. व्हेन वाज द मनरेगा एंटाइटलमेंट अवेयरनेस वीक कंडक्टेड बाय द स्टेट्स और यूटीज? टू अवेयर वर्कर्स अबाउट देयर राइट एंड राइट्स एंड एंटाइटलमेंट्स अंडर द मनरेगा. मनरेगा के अंडर जो वर्क्स के राइट्स और एंटाइटलमेंट्स हैं उसके रिगार्डिंग अवेयरनेस क्रिएट करने के लिए देयर वाज अ वीक दैट वाज कंडक्टेड बाय स्टेट्स और यूटीज, स्टेट्स एंड यूटीज टुगेदर. द नेम इज मनरेगा एंटाइटलमेंट अवेयरनेस वीक. सो द क्वेश्चन इज व्हेन वाज दिस ऑब्जर्व्ड. सो रिमेंबर दिस वाज ऑब्जर्व्ड फ्रॉम 27th अगस्त टू 2nd सितंबर. जस्ट इतना ही पढ़ना है, इससे ज्यादा इसमें पढ़ने की कोई जरूरत नहीं है. जस्ट रिमेंबर द डेट्स. 27th अगस्त टू 2nd सितंबर वाज द वीक व्हेन दिस मनरेगा एंटाइटलमेंट अवेयरनेस वीक वाज कंडक्टेड बाय स्टेट्स एंड यूटीज अक्रॉस द कंट्री. And what was the objective of conducting this? It is to aware the MNREGA workers regarding their rights and entitlements under the MNREGA. All right. And MNREGA, guys, we all know it is being implemented by the Ministry of Rural Development. It was this scheme, this act was enacted in the year 2005, and under this, the rural people are provided with the employment. Minimum 100 days ka employment unko diya jata hai. Okay. Now let's move ahead to question number 5, which is the last question for today. Which of the following power company has laid the foundation stone for first ever electric vehicle charging station in the state of Meghalaya at its office complex? Meghalaya's capital is Shillong, and who is the chief minister? Conrad Sangma. So this company, let's talk about this news. This company, guys, is Power Grid Corporation of India Limited, PGCIL. And do remember that PGCIL is a Maharatna. It is a Maharatna company under the Ministry of Power headed by Mr. R.K. Singh. And there are total 10 Maharatnas in country. It was incorporated, it was established in the year 1989, and it is headquartered in Gurugram. Gurugram, of course, is in Haryana. So PGCIL has laid the foundation stone of the very first electric vehicle charging station in the state of Meghalaya at its office complex only. Apne office complex mein hi lagaya gaya. Agar pucha jaye ki office complex कहां पे लगाया है, तो यू कैन से दैट इट हैज बीन एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन द ऑफिस कॉम्प्लेक्स. ऑलराइट. नाउ दिस स्टेशन इज बीइंग डेवलप्ड अंडर द फेम इंडिया मिशन फेज 2. नाउ व्हाट इज दिस फेम इंडिया स्कीम? फेम इंडिया स्कीम क्या है? फेम स्टैंड्स फॉर फास्टर अडॉप्शन एंड मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ऑफ हाइब्रिड एंड इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल्स. फास्टर अडॉप्शन एंड मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ऑफ हाइब्रिड एंड इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल्स इज द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ फेम. दिस स्कीम वॉज लॉन्च्ड इन द ईयर 2015. It was launched in the year 2015 in order to promote the usage of electric vehicles across the country. Its second phase started in the year 2019 and it is targeted to be completed by the year 2022. 31st March 2022 tak isko complete karna hai. All right. And under the scheme, the Power Grid shall be developing 11 electric vehicle charging stations across in the Shillong cities. शिलोंग सिटी में जो उसका कैपिटल है वहां पे 11 इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल चार्जिंग स्टेशन बनाए जाएंगे. ऑलराइट. सो दिस वाज अबाउट दिस न्यूज गाइस, एंड नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. क्वेश्चन इज व्हिच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग पावर कंपनी, सो दैट्स पीजीसीआईएल, पावर ग्रिड कॉर्पोरेशन ऑफ इंडिया लिमिटेड. ऑप्शन ई विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर. ऑलराइट. सो गाइस, दैट्स इट फॉर द सेशन. आई होप ऑल द क्वेश्चंस आर क्लियर. इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट्स यू कैन आस्क मी इन द कमेंट सेक्शन. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग. गुड बाय, टेक केयर एंड गॉड ब्लेस.